Alright guys, what is up? Tadashi here, and we're about to get this Clannad visual novel playthrough started, so I'm just gonna tweet out the link real quick for those of you who do want to come and hang out. By all means, come hang out. Alright guys, live and streaming the Clannad visual novel. Come hang out. Come hang out as I play through the fields. It says I'm not online. That's kind of weird. Why does it say I'm offline? Okay. What's up, guys? I am apparently live now. Still don't see it. But I will trust your guys' words. Alright. I'm excited. Who's excited? I'm excited. Let's go. Okay, so Tadashi here, like I said before. We'll be doing a playthrough of the Clannad visual novel that I just got from Sekai Project. Gonna be super cool. I don't know how I'm gonna do this, whether or not I'm gonna narrate and read every single line. I might. We'll see. I don't know. But anyways, let's get this thing started. Let's go. Ooh, the sounds of the menu. Miss those sounds. Alright. New game. And hopefully this game doesn't crash on me, because it actually has been crashing. It could be the compatibility, so I did change it. Hopefully it's good, but not a big deal if it crashes. This is the beginning, and we can fast forward through everything. Okay, the world is covered in white snow. Yes, it's snow. Even now it continues to fall, coating me in its paleness. Ah. What could I be doing here? Better yet, how long have I been here? My hand is buried in snow. It's holding on to something. I pull it out. It's a pure white hand. A girl's hand. Oh, yeah, that's right. I wasn't alone. I wipe away the snow on her face. Her profile, sleeping peacefully, appears before me. Oops, one's in. Yes, this girl and I have always been together. Here in this world, this empty, sorrowful world.
hate this town.
There's too many memories here that I'd rather forget. Every day is the same. Go to school, see friends, come home to a place I can't stand. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will change if I keep living like this. Man, I have this thought every single day. Every single day. I wake up and it's the exact same thought. I wonder if my life will ever change. What's up? What's up, Joshua? There's nature almost everywhere you look around here. I guess today is just another day of trekking through the mountains to get to school. The trip would be so much easier if I could just level them all. If I were able to go in a straight line, I'd probably save myself 20 minutes. Yeah, probably. 20 minutes every day. How much time would that save me a year? Don't do this math. That hurts. I can't figure it out. It's the main street to the school, too. Normally, there's students everywhere. Today isn't a vacation day or anything like that, either. So I guess that means I'm late. Responsible students don't just stroll into school at this hour of the day, after all. That's me, though. I showed up late all the time. Oh my gosh. I don't know. I couldn't help it. It's because I was a slow walker. I didn't like walking fast. I like taking my time. But I wasn't a delinquent. No. Still, I continue walking at a leisurely pace, unfazed by my realization and the deserted scene before me. Meters left to the school gates. I stand still for a moment. Sigh, I exhale dejectedly while gazing up at the sky. Nothing much, man. Just excited to get this Clannad playthrough going. I love this anime. I love this visual novel. It's my second time reading it, by the way. Alright, there stand the school gates all the way up there. Whose idea was it for school at the top of the giant slope anyway? I wish my school was at the top of a slope so I can walk down with a nice high school girl. But alas, my school was completely leveled. Anyways, the hill goes on like a never-ending nightmare. Sigh. There's another sigh, but one much smaller sort of than mine. I look to my right. The music cued in. You guys hear this music? Tell me if the volume's not loud enough. I can definitely turn it up if need be. But yeah, just let me know if there's anything wrong. I'll do my best to accommodate your guys' needs because that's what I do. Anyways. Nagisa. A girl is standing there just as still as me. I can tell from the color of the school insignia on her uniform that she's also a third year student. But she isn't someone familiar to me. Her short hair that comes just above her shoulders flutters in the wind. She seems to be on the verge of tears. As a repeat offender of late arrivals, I'm not bothered one bit. She, on the other hand, seems far more concerned. The idea of getting to class this late must be pretty upsetting to her. She stares up at the school gates. Huh? She's talking to someone else. Someone in her head, I guess. I wonder how he, or perhaps she, replied. I know. I can't help it. I can't help it, Johnny boy. Let a man dream while I can. I wonder how he, or she... Oh, I just read that. I'm a baka. Baka. Totemo suki desu. If you guys have any suggestions on how I actually play through this novel, feel free to let me know. Doesn't hurt. Does not hurt. That's not Haruka. Hey man, don't throw under the bus like that. Oh, and also, how's the stream overlay? I put this together recently. Still testing things out here and there. I don't know how. Oh my back. Yeah, but you know, this looks fine to me. Volume levels are pretty fine, I assume, since no one's complaining. She continues to talk to herself awkwardly. Even if things change, will I still be able to enjoy it here? You know what, Nagisa? I'm not gonna say anything. Because I already know what happens. There it is. You just have to find more. That's it. That's my boy, Tomoya. And she just realized you're there. Koyoto. And you just have to find more things that are fun. More things that make you happy. That's all. That can't be too hard, right? Well, beg to differ. Uh-oh. The sakura flutters in the wind. I remember those days. What it felt like to be naive, simple shit. But yo, this soundtrack though, I'm probably gonna comment on this like a billion kajillion times as we go through this novel. It is phenomenal. Oh my goodness. Anyways, come on, let's go. Up the hill. We start to climb the hill. Here we go, boys. Go for every bad ending. You know what? That'd be fun. That definitely would be fun. April 14th. Let's go. What's today? Today's, not even April. My bad. Tsunohara. You know what? Actually, I'm gonna save real quick. Get this first save data going. Can I leave comments here? Is this memo? The first save. Is it like glitched? What's going on? Oh, there you go. What is my delay at? You know, I think it's probably like 10 seconds. 10, 15, 20. Every time the stream buffers, the delay only gets worse. Thank you for a shitty internet. But I'm going to inquire about whatever, a different plan or something I can use just so I can make streaming better, because I actually do like streaming. I want to try streaming. This guy said, where's the action? Bro, do you know what Clannad is? There's no action. Jeez, man. Look to my side where Tsunohara's desk sits empty. Yep, that's nothing new. His attendance rate is worse than mine. Delinquents. He's really the only person in class I can have an honest conversation with. Nevertheless, today's classes begin. I spend them looking out the window. The teacher's voices go in one ear and out the other. Thanks, VJ. Class is finished, bringing the school day to an end. Tsunohara never did show. In fact, the only person I've spoken to all day is that girl from this morning. It really is just another ordinary day. Since I'm not part of any after-school club, I grab an empty bag, cut through a pack of jabbering students, and leave the classroom. Could go home, but there wouldn't be anyone else there at this hour. Not anyone I'd want to see anyway. I don't have a mother. I was told that she died in a car accident when I was still little. I don't even remember what she looked like. After her passing, my father sank into a pretty deep depression, probably due to the shock of it all. Using alcohol to numb his pain, he wasted away his days gambling. Wow, my phone just went crazy. Because of that, a lot of my time as a kid was spent arguing with him, actually. But one day, our relationship took a turn for the worse. He got violent with me. Seems like the delay is about... You know, the delay could be 30 to 60 seconds. Wouldn't be surprised. Internet's really poopy, so... Sorry about that. I don't think I can do anything about it. If it's not me, that'd be cool, but I'm assuming it's me. Yeah, it's all good though, right? I hope. Anyways, back to the novel. He got violent with me. Ever since then, my father stopped showing his emotions. He's also stopped calling me just Tomiya, instead calling me Tomiya-kun, as if we're nothing more than strangers. It's like he was retreating into some kind of shell, as if he's trying to sever the present from the past. Oh man, Tomiya's dad. Tomiya's dad, though. Hurts so much. I can't stand being home anymore. That's why I stay out so late now. If I come home when I know he's asleep, I don't have to see him. That's why I go to bed at dawn, of course, and I don't wake up until noon. I've been late almost every day since starting high school. I've spent my life like this for almost 3 years now. Today's no different either. I go home just to change out of my school uniform, then leave again before my father gets back. The routine practically feels ingrained in me at this point. I wander around town aimlessly until nightfall. No matter what, I always end up at the same place. On my way, I grab some takeout from one of the local restaurants. I carry it with me as I walk down the massive hill from this morning toward the school dormitory. Yeah, I had to lower my bitrate because my internet's that bad, and I don't know, I could lower it some more if, I don't know, because the higher I put my bitrate, I remember I was experimenting, and it was, like, really bad when I went, like, over, like, even over 1,000. So, like, I think right now it's set to, like, 600, but it wasn't a problem before. Like, I was able to stream without that many interruptions. I don't know. I could lower it some more. I don't know if that'll look great. Ooh, Johnny boy, my bad. Well, we can always hang out and chat. Hold on, let me open up the stream on my phone. Not using my internet and see where exactly we're at right now. He doesn't have the money to move though. He still lives in the dorms where all the jocks are. Because you're a jock, homie. In front of
I wander around town, even until nightfall. No matter what, I always
You should listen to the lyrics. Sunohara, you were so cool. Low key. Mumbles the words under his breath. He won't be able to hear you like that, you know. Damn it, stupid rugby players! Oh, this part was so funny in the anime. Are you trying to get me killed? You're the one who said it. Listen, Okazaki. My relationship with I'm sure you guys can read that, right? Nah, I'll also read it. I'll read parts of it. Well, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I don't know, wakaribasen, I don't know. I still have another year left here. I don't back down from one-on-one fights, even if it means fighting one of the rugby guys. Is that the only other team with me? They're all in the same in the rooms around us. I can't make trouble here. I'd be totally outnumbered. But I guess I wouldn't mind. How can I? You know what? There you go. I'll be counting on you to have my back then, alright? Great, I'll be sure to take a shot of my own at you while I'm at it. I'm on the rugby team side, you know. But I will be here when it all goes down. Boom. Shizukana. I'll kick the wall right back for you. You get scared way too easily. I can just imagine all this stuff animated. Beautiful. These are definitely fun moments. Fun, funny moments. Holy shit, that's so fast. I wish, man. I settled down in a small room between the wall and the ever-present Kotatsu. I want a Kotatsu. Someone gift me a Kotatsu. Donate me a Kotatsu, please. I will love you forever. Sorry, could I get some tea? No. Think I'm gonna serve you tea? Hey, I said I'm sorry. I don't care if you apologize. What do you think this is? The cafeteria? We're in your room. I understand that. And you're my maid here, champ. Yes. Please, I forgot to buy some. But I thought you wanted to do anything you could to be of service to me after I saved your life. No?
So
happened. That's what you told me after I saved you, though. That man named Sunahara died long ago. Before you now stands your loyal attendant. I am but a simple tea servant. That's what you'll say to me. So tea, please. This is a nice friendship. Like, honestly, I think it's a lot of fun. You'll definitely want to pour me some once you hear it. You seemed done for after suffering life-threatening injuries, but I, thirsty, ordered you to make me tea. So you summoned up the last drops of your strength to go brew some, even as you groveled on all fours. And then, Okazaki-san, here's your tea, sir. And this cup will be my last. You died with a smile on your face. Man, I sound remarkably satisfied in that story. When you're dead, so it doesn't matter. Well, it was exactly how you'd wish to go, after all. Cool. Nevertheless, I sat there, drinking that final cup of tea as I cried. See? Moving, isn't it? So, tea please. Yawn. About time to go to sleep. It was late, and the date had already changed over. Wow, past midnight?
Alright, I'm gonna go take a shower. Okay.
So I'll leave while I still can. I close the magazine and get up off the floor. As I do, I find myself looking at a cassette player. Oh, here's the tape. Turn this up. Yeah. I'll start doing these saves. And recording my voice over it. 110%. We're gonna be a fuckboy to Sunahara. A rap day dedicated to my close friend Sunahara. Do you want me to... I forget if he actually raps it. Just like the words come out. If he does, I'll rap it. Yo, my name is Okazaki. And that's all we got. I quickly get discouraged. Why am I doing this for him? Considering our relationship, you probably couldn't even call us super close friends to begin with. I don't know, man. I beg to differ. Alright, April 15th, boys. Hey, Nagisa! What's good, girl? Oops. Again? Why can't you go up the hill on your own? Her voice is so soothing. You don't know me after all. But you really should get to school on time, like a good student, not like me. Oh, there it is, her stern attitude, her sense of justice. Ooh, I almost touched the stream. She points straight at me, her eyes burning red through my thinly veiled reticence. I've never heard that word. Nice. Forget about me. I look away, unable to meet her gaze any longer. She's just as much of a delinquent as I am. Do what you want. I stood up the hill without her. It's just, what drew me to her was the fact that she didn't really look like a bad student, because she's not a bad student. She's Nagisa. Da, 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 da. That's all. Matte kudasai. A voice. It's hers. Of course it's hers. Ii desu. It's fine. That's it. Well. Furakawa. She has to have at least a friend or two, right? Little do you know her story. Hey, it's not too far away. Start walking again after repeating myself. What now? Anpan, there it is. Anpan. I don't remember. I should remember because I've rewatched Clannad like 1,000 times. But did she say Anpan their very first meeting? I feel like she did, or she was supposed to, but she didn't in the novel. I don't know. I gotta go back and watch it one sooner or later. I don't know. Anpan. Oh, I don't know if you noticed, but it came up in the little, what's it called, the Dangorepedia, or I don't remember. How should I even reply to something like that? Baguette. I didn't realize. I forgot he gave that lame answer. You like Anpan or something? Oh, that actually makes me kind of hungry for some bread. I want some bread. Nagisa is just too pure for this world. Has the stream buffered or lagged for you guys lately, or is it decent now? And we're back in class. The bell rings, ending the period. Oh, here she is. I'm sorry, I don't know your name yet. Female student. And there it is. Ryo Fujibayashi. She's the class president, I think. She's Kyo's younger twin. Kyo, best girl. She insecurely darts her eyes left and right as she's standing next to my desk. Kore. As she hands me a sheet of paper. A love letter? She's all flustered. It's not easy to just hand that to me directly. そんなのじゃないです. Chain letter? Chain letters, grade school emails everywhere. Oh my goodness. They're so stupid. They're everywhere. Absolutely everywhere. A letter of challenge? She got a little angry there. That's cute. Anyways, she's always been this cute girl. It's a shame that... I don't want to say anything else. Oh, dasai. Lame. Do you need something else? I think you should try to come to school more often. Alright, I feel you. So you think you can start picking on your classmates' attendance now that you are the class prez? Her eyes start to water. You made her cry, you bastard. Apologize. Ignore her. Choices. Choices, choices, choices. I'm gonna apologize. We'll go appreciate these aren't triggering anything yet. If I recall correctly. I'm sorry. Made her cry. Her sister will come. That's what you think. You can't say that when you're on the verge of tears. In any case, since no tears have actually come out, let's just say she isn't crying. Alright, fam. Well, I'll consider it. Johnny Boy? The Dangopedia. I'm just charging my phone. This is what it looks like. So, all these words that are highlighted red as you go through the novel get added into the Dangopedia. And see, I have these new words here. Anpan. And it's basically a translation, an explanation of what that is. Because for us English speakers, we're supposed to not know about these things. But me and many of you guys being the weebs we all are, know a lot of these. But yeah, that's pretty much what it is. Bento explains what a bento is, dango, all these things. So, honorifics, Japanese education system, what the fuck? Kotatsu, I want one. Yeah, so that's all right there. Nice little feature they added, and yeah, as we go through the novel, they are highlighted in red, which is pretty cool. Alright, anyways, so it looks like Ryo is doing her tarot card fortune telling, and of course, they scattered and fell on the floor. She manages to do it this time. Fujibayashi clumsily fans the cards out and holds them out toward me. Eh? Nani kore? Should I pick one? Sanmai. I know that. I have no clue what's going on. Is she trying to show me some sort of card trick? In any case, I take three cards. She stares at the three cards I had chosen. That wasn't a good we'll be late tomorrow. Well, if the cards are telling me we're gonna be late, looks like Tomoya's gonna be late. Is she trying to pick a fight? On your way to school tomorrow, there will be an old lady who'll have trouble crossing the street. You'll be late because you help her. But she'll be grateful for your help and give you some money for your trouble. Why is your fortune telling so detailed? You know what? Good question. I wouldn't believe that. Much less playing cards. How can you possibly tell all that would happen with just numbers and suits? It's a girl's intuition. Her sixth sense is in full force. Man, I totally would make a straw poll, but the delay is like so huge. Like, you're probably hearing this. Right, delay. So you're definitely hearing this a lot later. But yeah, if and once I do upgrade my internet, where things are pretty much like a 10-second delay, or 10, 15, whatever. You said Twitch has that 10, 15-second delay. I just want to get enough so I can up my bitrate and not delay it so much. But once I do, I'll definitely be making polls. And of course, once I get more viewers, cause that'd be nice to have a whole bunch of people in chat choosing my fate. But I'd have to find... I definitely want to do that with, like, a... a visual novel with like dire consequences. That'd be pretty cool. But yeah, as of right now, it's Astropol isn't really feasible because my internet is so poopy that even I wouldn't want to vote on Astropol. Oh wells. Eh. Even if I come across an old lady at Trouble the Cross, I'll pretend I don't see her. No, I'll abandon her. Demo! Ding dong. Go back to your seat. Hi. Hi. She's making me feel depressed. Please don't take the fortune too seriously. Interesting. Maybe she's really trying to pick a fight after all. Having been told such a weird fortune, I am feeling kind of blue. As I rest my head on the table after third period, I hear a loud bang come from the seat next to mine. I look up to see that Tsunahara has slammed his back onto the table. What's wrong? You seem to be in a bad mood, and it's not even noon. I had a fantastic morning. I bet you did, Omi. After I eat breakfast, I normally make myself some coffee and go back to my room. Nothing makes me happier. Oh, here it comes. I push the play button on my cassette player instead of drinking my coffee. Ooh, the cassette player. One of a kind mixtape with all my favorites on it. Ooh, rip. Ah, so graceful. Here it comes. Sip. Yo. Yo, yo, my name is Okazaki. You're Why are my awesome songs replaced with your nonsensical rapping? Didn't even finish rapping, but it's whatevs. My name is Okazaki. Don't get so mad. I was trying to do something nice for you. Because we're best friends, right? Even if it were any good, I'd still be mad at you. Why I was rapping you about all your special, about all your best qualities. What are you saying? I'm in the wrong. Left it on record and went home. Oh. Damn, that sucks. Who cares about those lame old songs? That's really, bro. Who cares? I don't care. You know what? That's impossible. You know that's impossible. Then go around the CDs and remake the whole mixtape. Don't ever record over my tapes. The banter between these guys is actually pretty funny, especially since Okazaki Tomoya does not really hold back. Pretty straight with Tsunahara. You learned a good lesson. Do say, always be sure to break off the recording protection tab on the cassettes you love. To hide things that are important. I'm sleeping until noon, don't bother me. Yeah. Skip class, sit through class. Well, boys. We're skipping class. Hey! I leave the classroom and head over to the old building. I tiptoe my way down the hallway. Most of the classrooms here aren't used anymore. They'd give a culture club one of these rooms if they applied for it, but now they're just being left as is. I sneak into the empty classrooms unnoticed. I find a chair, sit down. I go to the trouble of being truant and all I do is kill time. When will my life change? Will there come a day when it will change? Every day, man, I ask. Someone I knew said that once. The guy must be really effeminate. They should put that in the Dongopedia. Like some English version where they tell you what words mean, because I've never heard that word. Effeminate. Effeminate. Nope, never heard of it. I close my eyes. Nap time. Library. Clothes hangs on the door. Guess who's in the library, boys? Is the music gonna cue in? Tall bookshelves and reading tables line the room. The curtains flow and flutter as if they're breathing. Beyond that, I see a silhouette. It's a quiet female student wearing a childish hair ornament. The emblem on her chest shows that she's a third year like me. For some reason, she's sitting on the floor. Maybe she feels sick. I walk closer and notice that she's immersed in a book. Is she playing hooky too? Sunahara and I are the only ones who'd be outside the classroom at this time of day. She doesn't notice me and continues reading. But then, she suddenly stops turning the pages. She found something. She takes out a pair of scissors. She positions the blades on a page and stops for a few seconds. It's almost as if she's meditating. And then, snip, snip, snip. She cuts through the book without any more hesitation. Hey! Hey! Where's VJ? VJ, this is for you. This is for you, VJ. It's your girl. In her rawest form. Her first appearance. Visual novel form. Sitting in the library. Mountain of books in a bag that probably belongs to you. Ooh, look at Kotomi. She's so... I mean, I don't know her name yet. What? You eat this. I accept the piece of paper to hold it. I don't eat it. It's not. I'm not a goat. Thanks, Captain Obvious. Do you want to eat paper? I don't want to eat it either. You're not hungry? I'm starting to get hungry. This is funny. Like, imagine a conversation like this in real life. It'd be definitely a weird one. But it's nice that, it'd be nice to meet an interesting character like her, though, in real life. Like, just come across some airhead library girl. But hey, life isn't an anime. Life is life. Anime is anime. We are just living in a non-anime world. Never mind, do what you want. I dropped the piece of paper she gave me on the floor. Books seem too specialized and expensive for a library like this. Property of Prefectural Library. Hey. Didn't your parents ever tell you to take care of the public property? To take care of public property. She takes a box from her bag and pops open the lid. Obento. Oh, I could use... Ooh, I'm actually really hungry. Totemoishino. Didn't ask. Rolled omelet with soup stock. Interesting. It does look good. Taberu? The one today isn't made of clay, huh? You'll get a tummy ache. You want to eat clay? I'm starting to get hungry. Me too. Our conversation isn't going anywhere and almost seems to be repeating itself. Hold on, I'm... Want some? She looks straight into my eyes and asks me again. Want some? There's a hint of loneliness in her voice. Ah. A hint of loneliness. Loneliness. The breeze from the window floats across her childish hair ornament. It makes me feel guilty for some reason. We're gonna eat it. We're definitely gonna eat it. I'll take a little. Squishy. She nods with a sigh of relief. Let us eat. Itadakimasu. Surprised they didn't put that in the Dangopedia. But I guess they did translate it. So there's no point. Hey! Unworldly is a good way to describe the way she acts. Good job, Tomiya. What should I do? I pluck a piece of the stew and toss it in my mouth. Into my mouth. Stew? It's so weird that stew's in a... I don't know, whatever. Whatever, Japanese people. I'm not gonna question your ways. It's cold, but well-seasoned. Considering this is handmade, I think she's a great cook. Yeah, you know what? She could be. Oh, she's about to say something as she looks at my face again. Oh, is she so? It's okay. What? Probably tastes amazing. If I recall correctly, Kotomi can cook. She smiles faintly. Want more? Lunch is over. Huh. She doesn't have much in that lunchbox anyway. I can't bring myself to take more. Sorry I bothered you. RIP. After saying that, I turn my back to her. Mata ashita. Ugh. I would love to see you tomorrow. And the day after. Ototoi. The day after. Learn that. I raise my left hand and answer before leaving the library. I'm assuming like that. I don't remember. It's lunch break, but Tsunahara is still sleeping in his desk. In his seat. Classic. That's me. That's definitely me in school. I slept all the time.
Is class over? I ended a while ago.
Like how long? Oh, this part's awesome. I'm gonna read this all. I'd say it's been about 100 years. That's right. This is a hologram you're speaking to. Yes, Tsunahara. You slept for 100 years straight. It's fallen into ruin. Yes, so before we part, treat me to lunch. Civilization's really been destroyed. Yeah, hurry up and get me lunch. I said hurry up. A hologram just kicked me. Was that future stuff a lie too? I'm actually a cyborg. Straight up. Oh well, what about the world? Is it? Well, what's going on? It's fallen into ruin. Seriously. I promise to work together with a cyborg Okazaki and live on. Yeah, it's as crowded as ever. It's because we got here late. You're too busy telling me that elaborate lie. It'd be so crazy if someone actually believed that. I would tell someone that just for fun. I still have to sleep. You could have told me anything and I'd have gone with it. Anyway, let's find a place to sit. There you go. Dangopedia Kitsudon. Kitsundon. Kitsun Udon. It actually makes me super duper hungry. I bring it to an open seat near the corner of the room and sit down by myself. Uh-oh. Wrong student. He's on the rugby team. What a dummy. What a baga. Oops. I thought you were freshman. That's the guy that who kicked out of my seat the other day. Hey, thanks for snitching on me. I get what's going on. Come on, we're taking this out back. Dang, Tomei, I just threw him under the bus. I leave the cafeteria as soon as I finish my lunch. She's eating bread on her own. It looks like... Isn't that cute? Ooh, it's her. We're going down. We're going down the courtyard. 110% we're going to the courtyard. I approach the girl and call out to her. Why are you here all by yourself? Munch, 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 munch. She really is eating anpan. Ugh, I'm actually so hungry. After this, I'm gonna definitely go get some food. Oh, my hair. Holy shit. Don't worry, I'm getting a haircut tomorrow. I'm getting a fresh cut. Munch, munch, munch. Hey, did you hear me? Oh my gosh, she's so polite! Oh my gosh! I'm in the middle of eating. Once she finishes her anpan, she begins sipping on a carton of milk. Oh, huh? Well, I read that completely backwards, huh? Oh. Oh, this music. It's like... Oh. Do you like this school? Like, honestly, just hearing these soundtracks actually pulls away my heart. It actually... I can feel my heart being... squeezed on. Nothing can stay the same forever. That's true. What she's saying is so sad, yet so true. Oh, Nagisa is so cute. Why is she so cute? Can you be more specific? I don't really understand. Aww, I guess school stopped being a place where I could have fun? Are you kidding me? You deserve every friend in the world. My heart. It hurts for her. It hurts for Nagisa. So, you took so much time off that it's become hard to talk to your friends. They formed their own groups while you weren't around. Heartless. Cue Kanye West. Kanye X Nagisa. They aren't at this school any longer. They all graduated. Ah, Nagisa. Rough life. How long were you away for? 9 months. 9 months. I would suspect Tomia to consider pregnancy. But obviously that never crossed his mind. I feel like Urashimi Taro. I actually want to look that up. Because I don't know anything about him. Dun, dun. The character from a Japanese folklore who was taken under the sea after rescuing a turtle only to return to his village to discover that 300 years have passed. Huh. That's why I was eating lunch by myself. Okay, thanks. I think I got it. I don't know what it is, but it feels like maybe I overset my boundaries there. I want to keep talking to Nagisa. None of it can stay the same forever. I recall her words. Of course not. Time is always moving forward.
Hi.
Remember what I said yesterday? You just need to find something else that makes you happy. If only it was that easy. We're all going to graduate soon. They're too busy getting ready for what's next. What about clubs? Clubs! Hey, clubs! Nagisa and clubs! Ooh. I see. Soka. But there is one I want to join. Drama club? Arimashita. So, go check out the club room after school. Then you should do it and put your whole heart into it. Yes, Nagisa, do what you gotta do. Good job, Tomiya, encouraging her. And we're back with Sunahara. I think of the girl I met during the break. It's crazy how, like, he didn't get her name yet. I wonder if the members of the drama would be welcome. Yeah. I realized something as I hear classmates scribbling with their mechanical pencils. No one's interested in doing that. We're all going to graduate soon. Everyone's too busy getting ready for what's next. So much me right here. Even though I graduated a while ago. Twice. High school and college. But, still preparing for what's next, quote on a billion quotes. What am I doing? That's me again. I've been staring at the window all this time, ignoring class. Fifth period ends. Only one boring hour of school left. But but two motorcycles have stopped near the school gates. Oh, here comes arrival of best girl. One of them waves his hand, signaling to the other. The two motorcycles start running wild on the school grounds. Here it comes. You bastard. Drawn in by the racket, the other guys have also started to gather by the window to see what's going on. There's just nothing more depressing than this. I wonder how the two- I definitely am watching this. So I decided to stay put and see how this whole ordeal turns out. A figure of a lone student. Here she is. Certainly calmly walking up to the two guys running wild on their motorcycles. Long hair, with a slender body. It was a girl. Wow, my chair is squeaking. It was definitely a girl. No way, this ain't fooling around. It's starting, here it comes. Tomio-san, kick their asses! More like she's the one to get her ass kicked. Don't ever underestimate Tomio! Oh, he didn't go down there. Is that an anime-only thing, or was I supposed to escape? I don't remember. You know what, I think I'm gonna ignore Tomio for now. I'm probably gonna go, to start things off, I'll probably go down Kotomi's arc, or one of the twins. Nah, you know, I think I'm gonna go down Kotomi's arc. I'll try to, maybe I'll change my mind, but as of right now, I'm just gonna stay away from Tomio. Yeah. Alright. I remain firmly seated at my desk. Where are you going? Half smile. You want to go take a look? He starts talking away. Her opponents were planted, in other words, it was totally staged. I'm not going to just let her be. Leave her be. Sorry, Sunohara. That was a good nap. You really are carefree. Yes, he is. Yes, they both are. You can't be serious. We're both broke. We're all broke. The world is broke. Oh my gosh, Tsunahara just spitting out of his ass right now. I feel concerned. I 100% feel concerned. Let's go see Nagisa. There she is. Gambare! I watch her for a while from a distance. The club room sits before her, its door closed. It could be bustling inside with would-be thespians practicing their lines for all she knows. The mere thought would surely be enough to give her the same out-of-place feeling she told me about this morning. You can do it, Nagisa. Gambatte. Come How does Buddy stay cool? Hamburger is what she said. For those who don't know, and they just translate that to Sal's Betty Staker. Rattle. Run over to her side, let's go. But yo, again, this soundtrack, ooh. It feels like my heart is being tugged along on a string. The drama club had been shut down. RIP. I plop my hand down on the girl's head. Ooh, Nagisa. Why is your hand on my head? Oh, Nagisa. My name's Tomoya Okazaki from Class D. What about you? Furukawa Nagisa. Nagisa. I can't say she's best girl, but she definitely, the fact, like, she's the type of girl where I wouldn't care if she won. That's the type of girl she is. Nagisa is that kind of girl. You just can't get mad at her. You can't not like her. She's just, yoroshiku onegaishimasu. This was the fated day that we met. Where could the drama club have gone? Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. How'd you know I wanted? I have a knack. She had lost everything she loved at this school. Oh, it hurts. It hurts the feels. Plus the music in the background. Why? Why do you do this to me? Baka. So in place of all that, she rewarded herself with food as a way to stay motivated and move forward. Ugh, my heart. Pan though, really? Dude, this soundtrack's killing me. They need to turn this off. Don't be late tomorrow. Sayonara, Okazaki-san. I return home before the sun sets. I quickly change and leave the house before my father gets back from work. Oh yeah, by the way guys, I'm going to, once this day ends, once it hits April 16th, that's where I'm going to stop this stream and call it a night. Because Clannad is a very long visual novel. I don't plan on streaming this every day. I might be doing it every... You know, actually, I'll talk about it once I finish. All right. Anyways, as I get to the dorm and begin my walk down the hall, a horde of giants barrels toward me. Whoa. I just barely move out of the way as they rush past. They were a bunch of rugby guys. Oh, best dorm mother. Here she comes. A lone woman. Misai-san. Though I don't live in the dorm. Oh my. It's impossible to not have not met her, seeing as I'm practically here every day. I'll talk to her. Misai-san's really nice. Yeah, I mean, they're just dumb jocks who got into this school on their ability to hit other dumb jocks over a leather ball. Rugby, guys. Speaking of rugby, rugby anime. I know Johnny Boy's hyped. I know Nikki Boy's hyped. I'll give him a speech. You can give me a speech. They'll just run off again if you do that. Put them in an arm lock until they shape up. That's where you use technique to trump power. What's up, Peeping Tom?
Hey!
Just a 180.
Hi, excuse me. 約束する.
Instant results. False confessions.
Eesh. Deadly
in its own right. I'm pretty sure you admitted to while scraping out in agony. Yeah, but I wanted to read some of these. Oh, and you're hearing too. Why do you have to read them beside me? Flip. Your master. Hey, what's up? You two are such good friends. I really will do this crossword. You are so weak-willed. What's the period from January 1st to 3rd called? 3-day vacation. I don't know what the answer is either. Is it like a Japanese holiday? I don't know. What's wrong with your answer? Okay, so you strip completely naked, then go to the room next door and knock. When they open it, you ask if you can borrow some of their soy sauce. When they look at you, just stand there proud as hell. What do you think? I wonder what kind of reaction they'd have. That'd be pretty funny. I can just imagine Tomoya laughing. If they started worshipping you for that, that'd be pretty messed up. Hold on, now that I think about it, I don't want either of those things to happen. For real, for real. You're such a wuss. Yawn. So can you leave? They say some creepy stuff happens late at night in this dorm. That's what I would do. Is the day over? Oh, we're going to. Okay, I'll do the illusionary world. I'm looking at it, a distant world. It's a dim, dark place. Where could this be? I think I'm inside a room. It's deserted, though. I can see a desk at last. At least, someone should be sitting there, but they're not. Not a thing here moves. Only time, as it passes by unflinchingly. I've never heard anyone use that word. Pretty interesting. If I were a new life, searching for a place to be born, I think that this would be the wrong place to choose. Yeah, probably. This world has already come to an end. Nothing will be born here again, nor will anything die. Even time doesn't exist in this place. Nothing new can come to an end. You can't ever escape. This is the frozen world I now see. I'll just close my eyes and leave this place. That's my thinking anyways. Please, next time I wake up, don't let it be here. Let it be a better, warmer world. Just then, I see a momentary flicker of light. Something moved. I don't know what it is, but I'm certain that something's here with me. I can tell she's still innocent. Her eyes are transfixed in my direction. Can she see me? She holds out her hand, but it doesn't touch me. Instead, it goes right through. Yes, I haven't been born in this world, so I can't be touched. But in that case, how did this girl notice me? Am I simply visible and that's it? That is the case, what do I look like then? How does she live? What nourishes her? That's a good question, right? What does she eat? I see this world again. Much of it is boring. It's a boring, unmoving place. All I can do is look at her back, but I'm certain that I had been longing for this moment. The girl's life is one of solitude. There's nothing here. No, there's no one here aside from her. That much is obvious. Like I said, nothing can be born here, and yet nothing can die. That's the nature of this place. That must be why she's able to look at someone like me yet never get bored. Items whose uses are unknown. Things that can only be described as junk. That body is for me. What a good girl. I'm still afraid of this place. The girl has her arm outstretched. I stare at her scraped and scratched hand. I become what I sought. April 16th, Wednesday. Alright, and that is where I'm going to call it quits.